morning and welcome to Bridge Street on this Monday morning, the last Monday of September. I am Jim Teske alongside Deb Cabral. Good morning.
It is so nice to be here, Jim.
It's good to have you here. And we're going to start off by talking about the fact that you were out of town and you missed out on some great weather.
It was
a great weekend.
It's so nice to be back up north to the warm weather. I was in Atlanta all weekend. I spoke at a conference, Forever Live. It's a company that I do a lot of business with. They do permanent online photo storage and sharing. And it was so exciting. Okay, we're going to Atlanta. I never saw the sun. It was cold and rainy, and thank goodness we were indoors in a beautiful hotel.
Yeah, you miss sunshine, 70-degree weather each day.
My husband reminded me every day.
quite frequently. And now we're getting a little bit of rain, which is good news. Over the weekend, I took advantage of the nice weather. We talked about it on Friday's show. They had an open house for the Lakeview Amphitheater, which is on Onondaga Lake. They opened it up to the public. And this is a picture of me. I was there.
Playing guitar.
I don't really play guitar. It's just for looks.
But you know what? If I squint, it kind of looks a little like you look like Peter Frampton a little bit, to be honest. You really do. Have you seen him lately? No.
Well, he doesn't have as much hair now.
No.
Okay. So maybe I could,
you look like Peter Frampton.
I could be a body double for Peter Frampton, maybe. But no, it was neat. You were able to walk on stage and just see what it's like for
cool.
the artists. And they got the beautiful lawn there. And the thing is that there's a bike path now on that west side of Onondaga Lake. So you can walk or ride your bike, and it goes right through where the amphitheater is. So you can go through there, take a break, sit up on the nice lawn, take a look over Onondaga Lake.
That is so amazing. When are the concerts going to start?
Next year. Mm-hmm. But we don't know yet. We were talking to Joni Mahoney, the county executive, Friday, and they're working on it right now.
Good.
We may hear something before
That's
the
amazing.
End of the
we're
year.
We're going to have some good people, I think, because you're going to, how many seats is it?
5,000 permanent seats, but on the lawn, thousands more. I don't think they've
kinda
figured out
back.
Exactly how many at this point.
Mm-hmm.
So stay tuned for that. Maybe when you're out at the amphitheater, you might have a beer, because today
is national.
National drink, not just National Beer Day, National Drink a Beer Day. So, you know, and this is something that we found some quotes from some pretty famous people with their comments on beer. I'll just read a few of them. Beer is proof that God loves us and wants us to be happy. That was spoken by Benjamin Franklin.
Love that. Well, listen to this one. Beer, if drunk, I like drunk. The word, if drunk in moderation, softens the temper, cheers the spirit, and promotes health.
See, the founding fathers, this
Thomas
is
Jefferson.
Thomas Jefferson, the founding fathers are promoting beer. Of course, in moderation.
Yes, in moderation.
And then here's one. Some people wanted champagne and caviar when they should have had beer and hot dogs.
That's good.
Dwight Eisenhower.
Yes, Dwight D.
A patriotic American right there.
And I like this one. I would kill everyone in this room for a drop of sweet beer. That is Homer Simpson.
beer. That's my Homer Simpson for today. So it's National Drink a Beer Day.
So have a beer, everyone, but not this early, I would
imagine. No, it's a little early. And in moderation.
Yes, in moderation.
Moderation. Last night, big show, astronomically speaking, the Blood Moon. Did you see it?
No, I didn't. I saw it on GMA this morning.
Oh, because, it's
beautiful
everywhere.
Beautiful photos.
You know, there's pictures everywhere.
Yes.
This is a once-in-a-generation super blood moon, because it was a lunar eclipse and the moon was close to the Earth, what they call perigee. It's its closest orbit to the Earth, so it looked a little bigger than normal. You won't see one of those until 2033.
Wow.
And it had that red glow. That was from Brooke Teachout, and he put that on our Facebook page.
So did you learn about that in meteorology school?
No, you would learn about that in astronomy.
Okay.
Because that's stuff that's way up
there. The GMA, they have a co-host, and he's a great guy. He's a football player, and
Palmer?
Yeah, did you hear?
What did he say?
He said, and this is great astrology.
Whoops.
So somebody's like, are you a Libra?
No, it's a little different there, a little bit different. So that was last night. And we'd like you to share any pictures that you may have taken last night. Go to our Facebook page at Bridge Street TV, and you can share that. And speaking with the celestial bodies, we're going to talk a little bit about Mars, because this came out. It was tweeted yesterday by NASA, and they said that they're going to have a major scientific find today at 11:30 concerning
so cool.
Mars.
Right. So 11:30 today. What do you think it's going to be?
Well, I think the speculation is that they may have discovered actual water on Mars. That may be the thing that they've found. I think the timing is interesting because there is a big major motion picture coming out at the end of the week.
The Martian,
which I read on vacation a couple of weeks ago, which is, if it's anything like the book, the movie is going to be outstanding. So I think there may be a tie in there. I don't know.
I know. So if there's water, then there's some type of life, I would imagine.
There could be some type of life, and that may help them as they go out. I know there's talk within the next 15 years or so sending people to Mars.
That would be cool. What we were saying backstage, that it would be great to send a man on Mars. And I said, well, what about a woman? Yesterday was my first flight ever. I've had like female co-pilots, but the pilot, the head pilot was a woman.
Wow.
And so when she got on and she was saying things, you could hear some of the people like, there's a woman flying the plane.
Now, why do people
We're safe, everyone.
Why do people have to?
She was great. And even the landing was very smooth into Syracuse. It was, yeah.
There you go. Maybe there'll be a woman piloting that first spaceship all the way to Mars.
Or maybe a woman president. You never know. We're not going to get into politics.
No,
but my daughter's name is Carly. So when Carly Fiorina, when they have Carly for president, I always tease Carly for
that
president.
That could be you. Well, we're going to bring it back down to Earth now because we want to do a little preview of Dancing with the Stars, which is tonight. Two people have already been kicked off, Chaka Khan and Victor Espinosa. Tonight, the Muppets, they're going to take over as well, along with the former winner, Alfonso Ribeiro.
He's going to be a guest
judge. He was going to be a guest judge. So, and the speculation is that Kim Zolciak from Real Housewives, she had a mini stroke last week while she's training.
Yeah, awful.
And the question is whether she'll be able to dance.
Right.
I don't think anyone
knows.
Well.
Wow, that's amazing.
So there she is, I guess, in the hospital when she tweeted. So the thing is, you see this now, the last couple of seasons of Dancing with the Stars, although not to this extreme, that people are getting injured
and
when
they're
training.
And look, she's in great shape. She's thin and healthy. Like, you wonder, how does that happen to a healthy person?
Yeah.
I'm glad she's, prayers to her. I'm glad she's doing well, but that's,
We'll find out tonight at 8 o'clock and, see if she shows up. And, we hope everyone had a good weekend, but probably you didn't have as good a weekend as Jordan Spieth. He's the phenom golf. I forget whether he's 21 or 22. My goodness, he won the U.S. Open, the Masters this year, and then he won the Tour Championship yesterday. They played that in Atlanta, by the way.
Really?
You didn't see the golfers there?
No,
some of
I
them
did
probably
not.
Stayed.
You know what? Actually, on our plane going there, there were a big group of gentlemen from Syracuse all in the golf, and I just thought, maybe they're going on a golf vacation we left on Thursday.
But anyhow, Jordan won this tournament yesterday. It's his fifth win this year, which brings his yearly winnings to $12 million. And then, on top of that, by winning this tournament yesterday, he gets an additional $10 million.
Wow.
So he pocketed...
Most eligible bachelor in the world now.
He pocketed $22 million
in
earnings. And that doesn't include endorsements.
Now, is that better than Tiger?
I don't think Tiger has won that much in a season. So that's a lot of money.
Amazing.
So he had a good weekend.
Good for him.
And then I think the final thing, we got time for one more thing? Okay, we're going to do this... Last week, it was last Monday, right? You were with us.
Yes.
Joseph's House here in Syracuse was doing a raffle, a Tahoe, to raise money. And here's the winner. She's a 12-year-old. She raised this money to buy the raffle tickets by the cans and bottles. $1,000 worth to buy the raffle tickets. And guess what she won?
Isn't that amazing?
But that isn't even the best part of the story, because she returned the Tahoe to the Joseph's House. And they're going to take that Tahoe and get two vans, so they're going to be able to use that. And just a reminder that the Joseph's House helps to women who have unplanned pregnancies, and so they traded it in for the vans, and they're going to be able to use it. The winning ticket was one of 26,000 tickets.
What an amazing 12-year-old, though. You know,
Erin Byrne.
Yeah, she's destined for greatness.
She's from Fairmount, so salute to her.
Excellent.
You
go, Erin.
Yeah, so great story
there.
Great story to end Host Chat this morning.
Yes.
You ready for a great show now?
I'm ready for a great show. How about you, Jim?
Well, I'm ready. We are going to have Dan Cummings. Our own Dan Cummings was down in Philadelphia for the Pope's visit, and he'll give us kind of a recap of what went on there this weekend.
And then we're going to be talking to Dr. Graber about weight loss surgery.
And you'll want to stay tuned to see how one charity race is going to benefit over 15 nonprofits.